Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to compare array and string. So I will be explaining what are the similarities and differences between array and string that are used in C language. Before starting, I just want to share one information. If you go to detail or description of this video, you will see links of various playlists related to C language. So you can watch them too. Now coming on to the topic. So if I talk about array first, so basically the meaning of array word is collection. Meaning of array word is collection. So it holds values collectively under a single variable. So if I write this, so it means we declared an array whose name is A. It will store 10 elements of integer type. So it means to store all integers collectively, you can declare an array. So this variable will be treated as array in this case. Now in C programming, we can declare array of any data type which are available to use. So here you can see three declarations are available: int, float and char. So A, B, C, these three are arrays of different types and they will be storing different quantity of data, right? So this is about array. Now coming on to string. So in case of string, we only use a data type that is char. And let's say this way I declared string. So string is nothing. It is basically an array. String is basically an array because you can see this statement is available here and I have mentioned this here as well, right? So this can be used in both the ways, in terms of array and in terms of string. So now you might be thinking, how we will identify like this is character array or this is a string. So you need to note this statement. So here I'm writing a string is collection of characters terminated by this null character, terminated by null character. So it is known as null character, right? So this way you can identify like if your character array is not having null character at the end, then it will be known as character array only. But if your character array is having a backslash zero or null character at the end, then it will be treated as string. So this is the basic difference between array and string. So arrays don't contain any null character, whereas string contains null character at the end, right? And in case of string, we can use only character data type, but in case of array, we can use any particular data type. Now you might be thinking explain more about null character. Why in case of string null is required, but why in case of array null is not required, right? So now I am going to explain this. So I am going to take example of this. So here you can see this is integer array whose size is 5, and I am removing this. And let's say here I am writing str of 5. Right. So right now both are arrays. Right now both are arrays. This is integer array and this is character array. But we are assuming that it will be containing null character at the end. So it will be considered as string further. So in this case where int a of 5 is written, so this array can store 5 different elements at different indexes. So let's say this is memory location and here we have these 5 indexes of this A array, right? So now let's understand how we will put 5 different values into this array. So if I provide 5 different values like this, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 all together. So as per you, these are 5 different values, but you are putting them all together and you are pressing enter. So what will happen? they are five different values, they will be considered as five different values or one value. So in case of numerical terms, it will be considered as a single value, right? So this single value will be stored in zeroth index. So you are providing five different values, but it is considered as one value. So this will not be a valid input in case of this integer array. So what you will do, this is invalid. What you will do, you will provide input like this, 11, then enter, 12, enter, 13, enter, 14, enter, and then 15, enter. So this way you need to provide values so that five different values will be stored at five different locations, right? So whenever we are working on numbers or we want to provide separate values for separate indexes, then we need to use this approach. And to read these values from user, you can apply this loop, because we require five different values. So scanf should repeat five times. We require five different values, so scanf should repeat five times. And with this logic, you will be providing these five values and they will be stored like this. So this is the overall process of array. We didn't pick this notation. This is incorrect and this one is correct. So knowingly, we need to provide each element separately by pressing enter. Right? Now I'm coming to this string. Right? So string is telling it string, let's consider it as character array. Right? So I'm going to read values for character array. So let's say I'm going to input any name. So I'm increasing its size to 10, right? And let's say I'm going to input my name. So here also, we have one scenario. So again, you can compare this. In case of integer, I provided 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 all together. So it was considered as a single input. That was wrong because it will go to only first location. So we divided it into five different ways by pressing enter key. Now, here in case of character, which input will be valid, this or this? How you will enter your name? By pressing enter key after each letter, or by typing whole name and pressing enter key once? So I think this will be valid and this will be invalid, right? So in case of character array, knowingly we want to type all the characters all together and we want to press enter key so that this will become a single input. And here we divided this input into five inputs, right? So to read this input as a whole, we don't require any loop. We just use this, or we can use a single scanf having %s and str, right? So getS or %s, they are internally capable to store all these elements and different locations. So here automatically name will be stored like this because of getS or %s, right? So they are particularly built for character arrays, right? So they will receive this Sanjay as one input and it will be internally baked and will be stored at different locations of character array, right? So now I hope you understood one major difference of how we can read arrays and how we can read character arrays, that is, that will be known as string. So right now I explain you a working of character array, but you can't say it as a string until you insert null character. So here you can see total 10 blocks are available, right? And let's say I am putting here 50. So here size is 50 and you are repeating loop five times. So when you will be executing your program, so you will know how much data you are providing as input because you are iterating it through a loop. So you will know five values are provided by the user, so you can process those five values. But here in this case, we are not rotating any loop. We are just reading input through getters or scanner. So if my name is having six alphabets, so six locations will be occupied. If in your name, let's say eight characters are available, so it will occupy eight locations. So here input is not having fixed length. So how we can identify where our input is terminating or where our input is having last value? So for that purpose, getters or this %s automatically inserts null character at the end of it, so that we can identify how many characters are entered by the user. So we need to search for this null character, where this null is available. Before that, all the characters are entered by the user. So this is the reason why we read character arrays as a single input, because we cannot split all the characters individually. And knowingly, we want to provide input together as a collective input, one input. And we need null characters so that we can identify the last position, because we don't know how many characters will be entered by the user at runtime. So I hope this way you understood the difference between arrays and string. So string has only two special characteristics. One is the input nature, that is reading all the characters as all together as a whole, one input. And at the end, it will be having null characters so that we can identify how many characters are entered by the user. And in case of array, always we are going to repeat or iterate a loop. So we will be knowing how many numbers or how many elements will be provided. So we don't require any null character, because we know actual quantity that is entered by the user. So this way, I hope you understood the difference between array and string and the similarities. So somewhere they are similar and somewhere they are having different working nature. So use array and string as per your requirement. So if you are working with name, address, and you want to read some information related to characters that are having alphabets, digits, and spatial symbols, so then you can prefer string in form of character array. But if you are using digits only, so you can declare int or float arrays. So in that case, you can prefer this array. So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. If you want to watch more programming related videos, open my channel, go to playlist. So there you will be having various variety of videos. And you can also go to detail or description of this video, where you will find links of various playlists related to C language. So you can watch them too. So thank you for watching this video.